put on the salt plus buffalo plus loaves equals pennies. Watch everything add up. Real History is all new. Saturdays at 10 on H2. In the 19th century, the 49ers plucked 70 million ounces of river gold from California's streams and ancient riverbed, valued at more than $80 billion. But this easy gold didn't last. The race was on to find the source of the river gold, the mother lode, and they set off into the mountains to investigate.
And this is what the old timers were really looking for. A big wide bay of quartz, filled with gold. It runs literally for miles through the countryside. They were able to mine millions of ounces of gold from sources just like this.
With the discovery of Mother Lode gold, prospecting changed from a solo quest to big business. Hundreds of mines sprung up all over California, employing thousands of men. Discovering what geological force had concentrated gold in California's mountains was a puzzle that would bamboozle scientists for decades. In 1853, the Allegheny Mine opened in Sierra County, California. Today, it's over 3,300 feet deep, with over 40 miles of tunnels, all leading to one special slice of rock in the mountains.
Here I am in the middle of the Mother Lode vein. It must be about 40 feet thick, and it goes down half a mile into the earth. This is the gold-bearing quartz vein that the miners were seeking.
Quartz forms from a lake, and as it solidifies, it somehow traps lumps of gold inside it.
It is loaded with gold. If we break these quartz veins open, though, we can see perhaps small amounts of gold within the quartz. This is just an amazing piece of quartz. You can see all the free gold in it. It's just bright and glistens. There are actually clues to how the gold got here within the quartz that was deposited with the gold.
Trapped inside the quartz are tiny bubbles of fluid. They are minute remnants of stream of water and minerals that once gushed up this vein. Analysis of these fluid bubbles has revealed the extreme conditions that created the gold seam.
That gold was deposited at 600 degrees Fahrenheit. It was a very, very hot fluid that brought the gold